Good day, dear students. Today the topic is of C++ language and it was developed by Bjorn Stoltrup. As we all know that C++ is an expanded version of C language, but it's a object-oriented language which revolves around the objects. That means each and everything is considered as an object in this, and each object has some attributes, that means some properties and the functions to perform. This video lecture is presented by Sarabjit Kaur, Assistant Professor in PG Department of Computer Science, and the topic is Constructors and Destructors in C++. And the contents which I am going to cover in this presentation are: Constructors, means what are constructors? Characteristics of constructors. Types of constructors present in C++ language. Constructor overloading, constructors with default arguments, and the last one is destructors. So constructors, the question arises why we need constructors. Like in a structure or an array, we can initialize the data at the time of declaration. But in some cases, like programmer fails to call the function which is used to initialize the values, then at that time that object is full of garbage. That means it will create a problem for the program, or it will halt the execution as there is no value assigned to those variables. So now what is the solution of such a type of problem? So the solution is to take the responsibility of initialization away from the programmer, and it should be given to the compiler. So compiler takes the responsibility and it does exactly what we are going to initialize. So constructor is invoked automatically when an object of its associated class is created. That means whenever we are going to create an object, then the constructor is automatically called. A constructor is a special member function whose task is to initialize the objects of its class, or the values are given to the variables of that class. It is special because its name is same as that of the class. That means one need not to worry about the name. It is called constructor because it constructs the values of data members of the class. There is no need to write any statement to invoke the constructor function. If a normal member function is defined for zero initialization, we would need to invoke this function for each of the objects separately. So, like when a class contains a constructor, it is granted that an object created by the class will be initialized automatically. That means whenever we are going to write like add a, suppose there is a class add and we have member functions m and n, and constructor add, as it's already mentioned that add, the name of the constructor is same as that of the class. Now in the definition of the constructor, we are initializing the 0 to m and n. That means now m is equal to 0 and n is equal to 0. So it not only creates the object of a class type add, but it also initializes its data members m and n to 0. Now here are some characteristics of constructors. These must be declared in the public section because constructors are called automatically when an object of that class is created, as we already know it. So if we declare it in the private section or in the protected section, then these won't be called. They are invoked automatically when the objects are created. They do not have return types, not even void, and they cannot return values. They cannot be inherited, though a derived class can call the base class constructor. In inheritance, as we all know that whenever a class is inheriting the properties of its superclass, then all the data members and member functions are the part of the derived class also. But constructors cannot be inherited and we can call it explicitly. Like other C++ functions, constructors can have default arguments. Like in some cases, if we are not passing any value to the constructor and we are giving any default value, then that default value is taken. Constructors cannot be virtual. We cannot refer to their addresses. An object with a constructor or destructor cannot be used as a member of a union. They make implicit calls to the operators new and delete when memory allocation is required. Like constructors are used to initialize the values. So if we want to initialize the values using new operator and we deallocate the memory using delete operator, then these are the implicit calls. When a constructor is declared for a class, then initialization of the class objects becomes mandatory. Now, types of constructors. We have three types of constructors in C++: default constructor, parameterized constructor, and copy constructor. Default constructor versus parameterized constructor. Now, what are default constructor and parameterized constructors? Default constructor, a constructor that is automatically generated by the compiler in the absence of any programmer defined constructor. Like in any program, if we are not defining any constructor, then default constructor is called. It has no parameters, and if the programmer has not written a constructor, the default constructor is automatically called. That means compiler itself generates a default constructor. Now, in case of parameterized constructor, a constructor that is created by the programmer with one or more parameters, then it's parameterized constructor. That means we are passing the values, or we are giving the values which are being initialized to some variables of the class. It has one or more parameters, and programmer should write his own constructor when writing a parameterized constructor. That means parameterized constructor is not created by the compiler itself. Now, next is copy constructor. So copy constructor is used to declare and initialize an object from other object. That means we have created one object and we are giving the value of that object to another object. In that case, all the data members' values which are given using L1 are passed to L2. And the different ways are like integer, integer, ampersand i. Here integer is the class and this is the constructor also, and we are passing the reference of that class type only. So different ways are, the second one is like this one, and the third one is we are assigning the values of one object to another object. So the process of initializing through a copy constructor is known as copy initialization, and we cannot pass the argument by value to a copy constructor. Here the reference is passed. Examples of these type of constructors, like in first one, default constructor. So in default constructor, here we have constructor without any parameter, and that is called the default constructor, and this constructor is used to initialize the values. Like whenever an object is created, at that time this constructor would be called, and the definition says m is equal to 0 and n is equal to 0. That means the data members which are present in this class, they are initialized to 0. And in parameterized constructor, what we need to do, we are going to pass the values in the form of parameters, and the values which are passed using parameters, those values are initialized or given to the data members of that class. And in case of copy constructor, the values are not passed by value, and here the values are passed using reference, and the reference is of the class name itself. So here we have one reference variable, that is ampersand a, and m is the variable of this class, and here the value is present in a.m. That means this object's m variable's value is being passed to this m, and same a.n is passed to m. Like function overloading, we have the concept of constructor overloading. Like a program can have many functions with the same name but a different list of parameters. So we can also do this with constructor overloading. In that case, every constructor follows the rules of being constructor. Being multiple constructors in a program is called constructor overloading. So every constructor must be unique to avoid any ambiguity, and every constructor should be defined with a different type of parameter list. That means signature must be different. So constructor overloading, the first point is C++ permits to use more than one constructor in a single class. That means constructor overloading is possible in case of C++. So here in this example, like we have one constructor with no argument, that means this is default constructor, and we have one another constructor with two parameters, and this is called constructor overloading. So here in this example, like we have class add and we have three constructors, add default arguments, add with two parameters, and add with copy constructor. So in case of default constructor, the values 0 and 0 are initialized to these two variables, which are the members of this class, add class. So in case of parameters, whenever arguments are passed, values are passed, in that case those values are assigned to these variables. And in case of copy constructor, the values of that object are passed to the members of this class. So the first constructor receives no argument, and the second constructor receives two integer arguments, and the third one receives one add object as an argument, and this is called constructor overloading because all the constructors have different signature. So whenever in main program, in main section, the object is created like this, add A1, then it would automatically invoke the first constructor to set both and M and N of A1 to 0. And in the second case, we are creating an object A2 and we are passing the values 10 and 20. That means here in M, in case of here, the A is given value 10 and the B is given value 20. So in this case, add A3, we are creating an object and we are passing the values of A2 object. Like here, the object is passed, that means copy constructor would be called, and the values present in A2 are 10 and 20. That means 10 and 20 would be assigned here in M and N respectively. Next is constructors with default arguments. Here it's the default constructor, and here we are giving one value is equal to 0. And this is also the default argument constructor. That means if we are not passing any value, at that time, this default value would be taken. So the default argument constructor can be called with either one argument or with no arguments. So when it is called with no arguments, it becomes a default constructor. And when argument is passed, then the value of the argument is considered. At that time, this default argument value is not taken. Next is destructors. A destructor is used to destroy the objects that have been created by a constructor. Like constructor, the destructor is a member function whose name is same as that of the class name, but it is preceded by dash sign. Like this, a destructor never takes any argument, nor does it return any value. It will be invoked implicitly by the compiler upon exit from the program or block or function, as the case may be, to clean up the storage that is no longer accessible. It is a good practice to declare destructors in a program since it releases memory space for further use, because if that memory space is occupied and the other variables or other resources are going to take that memory space, so it won't be taken up. Whenever new is used to allocate memory in the constructor, then we should use delete to free that memory. Here is an example. Like this is a constructor and this is a destructor. So destructor overloading is not there as it does not receive any parameter, and constructor overloading is there. Destructors cannot be inherited like constructors. Memory address of destructor cannot be used or referenced. It cannot be declared static or const, means that it's not constant. A destructor should be declared in the public section of the class. So the question arises, when is destructor called? A destructor function is called automatically when the object goes out of scope, like the function ends, the program ends, a block containing local variables ends, or a delete operator is called. This is all about constructors and destructors in C++. Thank you.